Hello everyone. Today we will start study non-metallic elements. Of the 170 elements known, only 25 are non-metallic elements. Unlike with metals, the chemistry of these elements is diverse. Despite rare relativity small number, most of the essential elements in biological systems are non-metals. It is hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus, oxygen, sulfur, chlorine, and iodine. This group of non-metallic elements also includes the most unreactive of the elements, the noble gases. The unique properties of hydrogen set it aside from the rest of the elements in the periodic table. A whole branch of chemistry, organic chemistry, is based off carbon compounds. Okay, let's talk about general properties of nonmetals. Properties of nonmetals are more variable than those of metals. Number of nonmetals are gases in the elemental state, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, fluorine, chlorine, and noble gases. Only one, bromine, is liquid. All the remaining non-metals are solid at room temperature. Unlike metals, non-metallic elements are pure conductors of heat and electricity. They exhibit both positive and negative oxidation numbers. A small group of elements called metalloids have properties characteristics of both metal and non-metal. We'll call it about metalloids later. Non-metals are more electronegative than metals. The electronegativity of elements increases from left to right across any period, from bottom to top in any group in periodic table. With exception of hydrogen, the non-metals are concentrated in the upper right-hand corner of periodic table. Compounds formed by a combination of metals and non-metals tends to be ionic, having a metallic cation and a non-metallic anion. Hydrogen. Hydrogen is the simplest element known. Its most common atomic form contains only one proton and one electron. The atomic form of hydrogen exists only at very high temperatures, however. Normally, elemental hydrogen is a diatomic molecule, the product of an exothermic reaction between hydrogen atoms. So this one is a diatomic molecule. Molecule hydrogen is a colorless, odorless, and non-poisonous gas at one atmosphere. Liquid hydrogen has a boiling point of negative 200 and approximately 253 Celsius degree, or 20 Kelvin. Hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe, according for about 70% of the universe's total mass is hydrogen. It's the 10th most abundant element in the Earth crust, where it is found in combination with other elements. Unlike Jupiter and Saturn, F doesn't have a strong enough gravitation pull to retain the light wave hydrogen molecules. So hydrogen is not found in our atmosphere. The ground state electron configuration of hydrogen is 1s1. It resembles the alkali metals in that it can be oxidated to the H plus ion, which exists in aqueous solutions in the hydrated form. On the other hand, hydrogen resembles the halogens in that it forms the negative hydride ion, which is isoelectronic with helium, 1s2. Hydrogen is found in a large number of covalent compounds. It also has the unique capacity for hydrogen bond formation. Hydrogen gas plays an important role in industrial process. About 95% of hydrogen produced is used captively. That is, it's produced at or near the plant where it is used for industrial processes, such as the synthesis of ammonia, for example. The large-scale industrial preparation is the reaction between propane from natural gas and also of product of oil refining and steam in the presence of catalysts at 900 degrees. This one is the process. So the product is carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas. Two very important products. In our process, steam is passed over a red hot cock. This one is a cock and steam, also product, the same products as carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas. The mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas produced in this reaction is commonly known as water gas, because both carbon monoxide and hydrogen burn in air. Water gas was used as a fuel for many years. But because carbon monoxide is poisonous, water gas has been replaced by natural gases such as methane and propane. Small quantities of hydrogen can be prepared conveniently in laboratory by reacting zinc with diluted hydrochloric acid. So product will be hydrogen gas and salt, aqueous solution of zinc chloride. Laboratory, you can use this flask, zinc, and this one is hydrochloric acid. If you add it drop by drop, hydrogen gas, you can collect this gas in flask in laboratory. It's very easy. Let's study compounds of hydrogen. Start with binary hydrides. Binary hydrides are compounds containing hydrogen and another element, either a metal or non-metal. Depending on structure and properties, these hydrides are broadly divided into three types: ionic hydrides, covalent hydrides, and interstitial hydrides. Ionic hydrides are formed when molecule hydrogen combined directly with any alkali metal or with the alkaline F metals, for example, calcium, strontium, or barium. For example, lithium hydride can be prepared from lithium and hydrogen. Calcium hydride can be prepared from hydrogen and calcium solid. All ionic hydrides are solid that have the high melting points characteristic of the ionic compounds. The anion of this compound is the hydride ion H-, which is a very strong Bronsted base. It readily accepts a proton from proton donor, such as water or acids. And the product will be hydrogen gas also. Due to the high reactivity with water, ionic hydrides are frequently used to remove traces of water from ionic solvents. Covalent hydrides. Covalent hydrides in covalent hydrides, the hydrogen atom is covalently bonded to atom of another element. There are two types of covalent hydrides, this containing discrete molecular units such as methane and ammonia, and these having complex polymeric structures such as complex with beryllium or aluminium. We will study some of these hydrides when we will study chemistry of aluminium, for example. Also some examples of molecular hydrides is water or hydrogen fluoride. We will also study these compounds later. Ammonia, water, and hydrogen fluoride are all polar molecules in which the hydrogen atom is a positive positive and polar bond. In this table, you can see the some hydrides with blue color. You can see covalent hydrides with some nonmetals or metalloids. Among them, the polymetal structures with aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium, beryllium and magnesium, and ionic hydrides that we about what we call we told today's early. Interstitial hydrides. The molecule hydrogen form a number of hydrides with transition metals. In some of these compounds, the ratio of hydrogen atoms to metal atoms is not constant. Such compounds are called interstitial hydrides, for example, depending on condition. Formula of titanium hydrides can be different. The Many of these interstitial hydrides have metallic properties such as electrical conductivity, yet it's known that hydrogen is definitely bonded to metal in these compounds, although the exact nature of bonding is often not clear. Molecular hydrogen interacts with a unique way with palladium. Hydrogen gas is readily absorbed into the surface of palladium metal, where it dissociates into atomic hydrogen. The hydrogen atoms then dissolve. We can call it dissolve in the metal. The heating and under the pressure of hydrogen gas on one side of metal, these atoms diffuse through the metal and recombine to form a molecule hydrogen, which emerge as a gas from the other side. Because no other gas behaves in this way with palladium, this process is being used to separate hydrogen gas from other gas in small scale. Hydrogen has three isotopes: the hydrogen, deuterium, symbol D, and tritium, symbol T. The natural abundance of the stable hydrogen isotopes are hydrogen, 99.98%, and deuterium is 0.015%. Tritium is a radioactive isotope with a half-life about 12 and a half years. In this table, you can see some of the common properties of water with those of deuterium water. Deuterium oxide is a heavy water, as it's commonly called, is used in some nuclear reactors as a coolant and moderator of nitrogen reactions. Heavy water can be separated from water by fraction distillation because water boils at a lower temperature, as you can see in this table. Boiling point of water is 100 degree, as this one is 101.4 degree. Another technique of its separation is electrolysis of water, because hydrogen gas is formed about 8 times as fast as deuterium during electrolysis, where water remaining in electrolysis cell become progressively enriched with heavy water. Interestingly, the Dead Sea, which is thousands of years, has entrapped water that has no outlet other than through evaporation, has a higher ratio heavy water and water than water found elsewhere. Although heavy water chemically resembles water in most respects, but it's a toxic substance. The reason is that deuterium is heavier than hydrogen, thus its compounds often react more slowly than those of the lighter isotope. Regular drinking of heavy water instead of water could prove fatal because of the slow rate of transfer D plus compared with that of H plus. in the acid-base reactions involved in enzyme catalysis. This kinetic isotope effect is also manifest in acid ionization constants. For example, the ionization constant of acetic acid with hydrogen, with proton, is this one, is 1.8 multiplied by 10 under the power of negative 5. But the same reaction with deuterated acetic acid is different, is 6.6 multiplied by 10 under the power of negative 6. So the smaller than constant with acetic acid with hydrogen. Let's study a reaction with hydrogen. Hydrogenation is the addition of hydrogen to compounds containing multiple bonds, especially carbon-carbon double bond and carbon-carbon triple bonds. A simple hydrogenation reaction is the conversion of ethylene to ethane. You can see it in this equation, to the addition of hydrogen to double bond, carbon-carbon double bond, and ethane can be formed. This reaction is quite slow under the normal conditions, but the rate can be greatly increased by the presence of a catalyst such as nickel or palladium. As in the Haber synthesis of ammonia, the main function of the catalyst is weaken the HH bond and facilitate the reaction. Hydrogenation is an important process in food industry. Vegetable oils have considerable nutrition value, but some oils must be hydrogenated before we can use them because of their unsavory flavor and they inappropriate molecular structures. This is sometimes it's too many double bonds, carbon-carbon double bonds present. Upon exposure to air, these polyunsaturated molecules undergo oxidation to yield unpleasant tasting products. In the hydrogenation process, a small amount of nickel is added to the oil and the mixture is exposed to hydrogen gas at a high temperature and pressure. Afterwards, the nickel is removed by filtration. Hydrogenation reduces the number of double bonds in the molecule, but doesn't completely eliminate them. If all the double bonds are eliminated, they all become hard and brittle. Under controlled conditions, suitable cooking oils and margarine may be prepared by hydrogenation from vegetable oils extracted from cottonseed, corn, and soybeans.